Today's opening faceoff brought to you by Corona Nissan, and we are underway. Ducks in their third jerseys, orange with black numbers, and they ice the puck immediately. Josh Morrissey leads the Jets in ice time, and he headmans for Kyle Connor. Rink wide, his feet into the zone, off the wing, handled by Gibson, as Roslovic got it to the net. Matthew Perreault, the one-time Duck, wins the puck back to Pionk, and a little tip by Lowry. Down was Gibson, and a big block on Perreault. Holzer's pass ricochets back into Winnipeg ice, and Silverberg gets there first. Circles the net, working on Morrissey. Got it into the slot. Big save. Hellebuck. He brings it back into the net with a no goal.
For Anaheim, Silverberg, boy, picks his head up, does a great job in the middle. Spots steal, and then Jones does exactly what you want him to do. Jam away at that loose puck before Hellebuck can cover it up with a catching glove. You can't shove a goaltender over the line with the puck in front of him. So,
never heard this from you before.
Yeah, it's very true.
So you're saying it's cold there? Well, Raquel tried to go up top short side as he pulled that forehand backhand quickly. He and Patrick Laine both have been heating up lately as Hellebuck hangs on to this one across for Getzlaf. Back for Cam, winds and fires off of Hellebuck to the corner. Heading to the front of the net to screen with Silverberg.
He was looking for assistance and gave Dallas his first coaching job as one of his assistants there. Actually brought him up.
Richie leads the league in penalty minutes. Pionk tees it up for Laine and a big rebound off of Gibson. Blake Wheeler. Top 10 in the league in power play points a season ago. Back for Neil Pionk. Can't pick the top corner as that one got the glass. Quick puck movement again over to Wheeler. Pionk, one-timer, score! Screen in front came from Kyle Connor, and I don't think John Gibson ever saw it.
Ducks really focused on taking Patrick Laine away. Here it comes, and you can see John Gibson didn't see that. Kyle Connor is standing right in front of John Gibson. And Pionk gets all of it. Coming in about 2 feet high. Takes very few penalties.
And he hits hard with his 6'1", 208-pound frame.
Wow. Off the post from Getzlaf. Couple of good opportunities at the other end. Two-on-one break. Getzlaf has got Troy Terry with him. Vitetto back defending. Getzlaf's looking for that top shelf.
Fight coming into this game. 6 over .500, they're minus 8 in goal differential in second periods, and there's a fat rebound for Jones that Hellebuck gets out to cut the angle on.
This misses by a couple of inches, and then a big fat rebound as Max Jones drives the middle of the ice.
And he'll backhand it in and go for a change. Larson with a quick reversal, it comes back to him, compliments of steel, but it's Perreault that got to it and threw it out in front. Lowry with a quick shot. Second period, the Jets, by virtue of a power play goal by Neil Pionk, have a 1-0 lead. Here's Getzlaf right down Main Street, and a blocker saved by Hellebuck.
That's a good stop by Hellebuck.
Airs it back rink wide. Delorier speeds in, bad angle shot right through the crease, comes left point to Lindholm. Oh, he just threw a wrister to the net, and Hellebuck was still on the far side of his goal. Richie using the wall to keep it in his skates. Kasha taps it to the line, Fowler across. The Branson shot high off of Hellebuck. Good job on the back check as Morrissey got position on it. Here are the Jets the other way. Wheeler gives it up. He was the trailer. He gives it up again for Ehlers, and he scores. Nikolai Ehlers victimizes the Ducks again. He now has 12 points, including 8 goals in 11 career games against the Ducks.
Sees the release of this puck. Good puck movement. Anaheim. Yeah, there's no way that John Gibson can see this shot. Right in front of the net, Morrissey, the defenseman, on top of the blue paint, just jumps up into the air, and he just completely takes the vision away.
Well, Wheeler has figured in both Winnipeg goals as he has assists, and the Ducks now down a pair. Hellebuck point blank makes the stop on Getzlaf. Nice little back pass. Gets it back in front to Terry, who's knocked down. Getzlaf again recovers as Connor had a hold of his stick. And Laine's pass picked off at the line. Getzlaf in the high slot. Hooks it back. Here's Fowler right down Main Street. Save. Rebound chopped wide by Raquel.
Well, Cam Fowler comes close to getting the Ducks within a goal here as it squeezes between the catching glove and the leg pad of Connor Hellebuck. I'll tell you what, Lucas Spezza does a great job.
Tomorrow night, the Jets will be at Staples Center. Speed through the neutral zone. Kasha releases on the puck and then releases the shot. And Hellebuck handles that one. Good Branson rims it around and in. Silverberg recovers in the high slot. Backhander wide. He had Jones driving the net and then off the wall. Henrique got it to the net quickly. Of Paul Maurice. Here's Connor with speed in the left pad. Saved by Gibson. Boy, he's got a good first step, doesn't he? He turns on the Jets. Now he intercepts behind the net.
Beat people one-on-one. Make it look bad.
Brownie comes up with it. Cuts to the slot as he was bumped by Pionk. Lost the handle. Delorier keeps it going. Grant to the front of the net as Delorier just throws it from a bad angle on goal. Terry comes right back in down the slot. Has it knocked off his stick. He'll get to it in the corner. Drops it for Getzloff. He's trying to get it in front now, just unable to walk out in front as it's covered by the netminder Hellebuck. Beg your pardon, now shooting the Jets 13-6 in this period. And it has less than a minute to go. Spezza's long bid is gloved off by Gibson. Perreault plays it back. Pionk wires it just wide.
Well, one thing we're learning about Neil Pionk is he can shoot the puck.
Spezza's shot is held by Gibson, and now a word from Hyundai. That's something that hasn't changed or evolved about Maurice since he first entered this league as a head coach with the Carolina Hurricanes some 20 plus years ago. Connor on the doorstep, and it's 3-0. Shifley from behind the net able to sneak it through, and Kyle Connor stays hot.
Anaheim had almost completely shut them down. But just like that, in the blink of an eye, Shifley's backdoor pass gets away from Corbinian Holes.
Brownie does a nice job to keep possession. Potato knocks it away. Grant got a stick on it, and Rowney trying to stuff it on the wraparound. It's under the left pad of Hellebuck, who will cover up. Francois is his backup, but he's only appeared in 7 games. Here's a turnover. Andrew Kopp has an angle, comes in on Gibson. Glove saved by the Anaheim netminder, and he reels the rebound in.
In the corner of the offensive zone, he's looking for Larson, and Kopp was just waiting on it. He intercepts and gets a real good scoring chance.
Feed the point, Lucas Spezza. Right back to Wheeler. Fires it off the side of the net, it was off the blocker of Gibson, who had to hold that near side post. Oh, turned over. It's Connor. Took a second to get the handle on it. Gibson made the save, and then a penalty coming up to the Jets. Liney immediately engaged by Rowney, and that creates a turnover. Grant shorthanded with Rowney. 2-on-3. Rowney in. Boy, he had a path. And his shot just wide. And the Ducks and Jets met here at Honda Center. Rowney did score shorthand. Here's Liney. Dusts it off. Glove save, Gibson.
He catches it. Moves forward. And John Gibson says, from the Anaheim defense to keep the pucks alive in the offensive zone now.
Raquel wins the puck again. Gouley's shot creates a rebound. That one got Hellebuck in the mask. And that'll bring a whisk down to 3.5 to play. 3-0 Jets. Lowry's pass handled by Kopp across to Perreault. Back for Kopp. Deep in his crease. Gibson makes the save. And a hooking penalty coming up to the Ducks. The right pad of the Anaheim netminder kept it out. And that'll do it. Connor Hellebuck has his second shutout of the season. Brian, I beg your pardon, and for that, he is our Mercedes-Benz star of the game.